Welcome to my new calculus channel. My name is John Gabriel. In this video, I'll be showing you how to derive the arc length using the first and only rigorous formulation in human history, the new calculus. So, if you've studied any of the new calculus at all, you'll know already that we have proved this statement here, and that this middle part here is exactly equal to this part in your mainstream calculus, where each of these f prime mu sub s is defined by the mean value in each interval. So if you have a curve like this and you divide it into equal parts, of m plus n over k, as you see here, then m1, m2, m3, etc., m sub 1, m sub 2, mu sub 1 actually, mu sub 2, mu sub 3, are all the x-coordinates or abscisses of this point here, where the slope of the tangent line is equal to the y length, or the y-coordinate length, okay? And one can, excuse me, one can find the integral using this formula, provided you know the antiderivative of a primitive function, and in the new calculus, every function is integrable using the Gabriel polynomial. Whether it's in, whether you like it in closed form, or if you like it in the form of a non-terminating series, but it can be done in closed form using the Gabriel polynomial. So let's see how to derive the arc length interval. Now remember, let's just go back here. In the new calculus, once you have this function here, you can just replace the mu's by x's to get the equivalent in mainstream calculus. Let's see how it's done. So to find the arc length, we use a distance formula for each of the segments that join the endpoints of each partition. So these here are the endpoints. And obviously, if we reduce this, we'll end up getting this expression here, and in the new calculus, this expression is equal to this expression on the right-hand side, which is the ubiquitous form of the arc length formula, okay? And you normally see it done using this approach in the mainstream calculus. So using the new calculus, the differentials dy and dx, which are not really these equivalence in the new calculus, are equal to these expressions here. And dx is obviously equal to m plus n over k. So since no yield form theory is used, the differentials are well defined, and we can use this formula to see exactly how you can find the integral even when k is equal to 1. So it doesn't matter what the value of k is. Using this approach, you will find the integral in whichever number of steps you choose according to k. And we'll see an example of it done when k is equal to 1. So let's proceed. The arc length of the function x cubed over 0, the interval 0, 2, is given by this formula, right? So now we can find the arithmetic mean of all the segment lengths by what are all the segment lengths? These segment lengths here, right? So if we had to draw in a little segment line, it'll roughly look like the arc length, but those are the segment lengths that I'm referring to. So we can integrate the distance formula obtained. And in the new calculus, this is a finite sum found using the means of each equal partition. So the arc length would be given if the derivative is stated in a way so that we can use the mean value theorem or the fundamental theorem. The fundamental theorem is derived in one step from the mean value theorem. And so we can actually find the mu and then calculate the exact arc length. So this sum here is a sum for k equals 1, but it will work for any k given the appropriate mu's. In the new calculus, every function has a closed form antiderivative, as I mentioned earlier. And of course, it's possible using the Gabriel polynomial. So we can find mu s as follows. To find the mean value for h on 0, 2, this is what we obtain. And to find the abscissa, we simply solve this equation. Okay, it means a root finding algorithm. And then we'll have mu sub zero, which we can just substitute back into this original formula, this formula that you see here. And it'll give us the exact arc length, okay? So, and of course, if you wanted to have more k's, it doesn't matter. The answer would still be the same. And this is possible because in the new calculus, this identity here is proved using a telescoping sum. Likewise, when we calculate the arc length, it also turns out to be a telescoping sum. And that's why this value is exactly corresponding to the arc length for that given interval. So I'll show you here in this illustration the different graphs. So we're actually calculating the arc length of this blue function, x is equal to f of x is equal to x squared. Its primitive or antiderivative is given by h of x, and the derivative is just simply given by the red curve. Okay? So as you have seen, there is no use of infinity, infinitesimals, or limits, which are all ill-formed concepts. And simply replacing the mu sigma by x gives you the equivalent in the mainstream. So given that the mean value theorem is used, the finite sum is always equal to the arc length, regardless of the value in the summand. That is k, this value that you see in the summand. In a future video, I will prove to you that all integrals are in fact line or contour integrals, and then show you that any definite integral, once again, is the product of arithmetic means. You can actually take a Riemann sum and show that it is a product of arithmetic means. I've written an article on that. I've also written an article proving that all integrals are in fact line or contour integrals. But I'll upload this particular PDF so that you can study it, print it out, and study it in conjunction with the video. And so from this knowledge, you can also derive Green's theorem, the divergence theorem, Stokes' theorem, which uses vectors, and it has a parametric form in the integral. You can then also better understand why the change of variables method works, how the Jacobian is used. And these are all clear to any learner of calculus using the new calculus. So I hope you have enjoyed this little presentation. I know it's a lot of information packed into a very short time, and if you already know calculus, you'll probably understand it many times better. In fact, it'll probably be the first time you've ever understood calculus, if you've really understood what I've been telling you during this video. And I'll hopefully produce some more videos explaining more of these concepts and how you can use the power of the new calculus and understand calculus in future videos. This is the New Calculus Channel. My name is John Gabriel. Till next time, goodbye.